For centuries, mankind has been intertwined in a battle of kindness versus cruelty. History has taught us that when we face adversity, kindness is the most effective weapon against indifference.
Nonviolence is the answer.
And as time moves on, we're often reminded just how fragile life can be without kindness.
Hospital admissions in the U.S.
Health Organization is now classifying the virus as a global pandemic.
When COVID hit, the world came together like never before.
You started seeing all these acts of kindness happening.
People were singing from the balconies and applauding at 7 p.m. for all the first responders.
And then that changed quickly.
We're looking at some of the biggest issues plaguing us today.
Someone wants me to commit suicide so badly, maybe I should just do it.
How can you hate me? You don't even know me.
It's very weird to think that I am in this world because of the kindness of an evil person.
We work on both sides of the gun.
I want to look at all these issues that we're facing from a perspective of kindness.
My mission is to better understand the concepts of kindness before it's too late.
Civil war. That's where we're heading.
We have to do something to reduce this conflict.
Why are you being so mean in trying to be good?
By talking with scientists and experts to understand the effects kindness can have on our body physically, mentally, and emotionally.
Very threatening thing to imagine that a lot of the beliefs you've been operating under may be false.
We're meeting people and hearing their personal stories on how choosing kindness changed their lives.
The kindness that's been shown to me, it's really saved my life.
I believe that kindness is the fundamental building block in our daily lives that can ultimately determine the fate of humanity. And I'm proving it with A Case for Kindness.